I'm about to whip somebody's
arm. From the Autoglass America studios, it's the Mike Calta After Show.
Happy hour. Happy hour.
Yes, today is a good day. Why? Because my name is not John Kerry and I'm not a hack realtor. This is the Mike Calta After Show, Hoppe Hour filling in. I am your host, Ryan Hoppe. 727-579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. You can tweet at me at Ryan Hoppe Radio. You can always email me, ryanhoppyradio@gmail.com. Up next is the best of Roger and JP. Then it's Drew Garabo Live with John Senning. Then it is the Cat Named Mo Show with Gareth and Spike. And then Johnny B.
This is my little brother, George.
So, my girlfriend is a huge nerd. Everybody goes, oh my God, how the hell did Ryan Hoppe get his girlfriend? As if I don't deserve one, but that's fine. I don't care what people say. But just know that we went to the grand opening of the Peppa Pig Park over there in Winter Haven. And it's very much what you expect. She's very big into nerd culture. And she's very big into wanting to go viral on TikTok, which is every single Gen Z ever. And let me tell you, first of all, call now 727-579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. Maybe you're in the car and you're on your way there. It is every single thing you would expect from going to a Peppa Pig park. Like, there's nothing there that you go, oh, man, they're really missing out on that besides food. It was a lot of fun. It's just very small. Also, I'm 6'8", and I was the only non-dad who's a dude. You know what I mean? Every guy there had a kid, and it was me and my girlfriend. She's, like, 3 years younger than me. I'm 28. I just said her age. So it's very, unique. Like, I feel like I saw my future right in front of me. And I've been having that recently. But you go like, I could see myself being a dad. I could see myself doing it. And you think that. For about 10 seconds, I went, oh, I want to be a dad. That sounds fun. I want to be a dad. That sounds fun. And then the worst thing happened last night, which made me realize that I am not ready to be a dad. The whole night, sorry about the levels being loud. The whole night, my cat over and over meowed because we just moved into a new apartment, and I will get into that in a second. But let me tell you, the whole night, I will spare you the pain. And it's infuriating because I want to be able to communicate to Luna that, hey, we're just at a new apartment. Everything that was in the old apartment is there, but we're just in a new apartment. But the whole night, and it's like so infuriating because cats are so cute, so it's hard to get mad at them. But it's pretty easy to get mad at them when you're sleeping and they're just in your ear. And I'm not kidding. Like, I know you might think, oh, Ryan's bringing some radio theater of the mind. I don't think that's accurate. No. This legitimately happened. So let me explain. So I live in an apartment complex. It's not the nicest, but it's nice. It's an upgrade from the shack I was living in on the side of the highway. That's not a lie. And me and my girlfriend moved in last year. Remember that big announcement on the Mike Calta show? Well, we got a deal in the beginning of December. They were like, hey, And they wrote that like cliche thing that apartments will send. They're like, wow, time flies when you're having fun. And we're about to essentially kick you out of your apartment and make you pay more if you want to be in this apartment complex. Like, if you're going to screw me, just kiss me first. You know what I mean? Because it was like they said, well, we'll either offer you a 7-month lease and then you can find one of our quote unquote affordable apartments, or you can move out now. You have 3 days to move because we moved on the 21st and then we had till the 24th. So we had 3 days. So me and my girlfriend were walking across our parking lot in our apartment complex, carrying the couch, carrying her egg chair, carrying the TV. And let me just tell you real quick, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I've always had respect for the hardworking average Joe and Jane that listens to The Bone, that does hard labor. Because radio is very mentally tiring. Radio is very much a job where you get brain fog, or as my shrink says, you get social hangovers if you are an introvert. Like, you're talking so much, especially when I'm here on the weekend. I love every second, but I feel very bleh afterwards. Like my girlfriend says, there's something called weekend Ryan because I'm a little grumpy. But radio is not hard work, man. We're sitting here. I mean, it's hard work to get ratings and that. But, like, when it comes to lifting things, unless you are working hard in promotions and you're working for the great Mike Olivero, the GOAT of promotions, let me tell you, it makes me appreciate my job because I have so much respect for anybody out there that has a hard labor job, because I hurt my back this week. And then I also, like, sprained my knee. And that was just from carrying things. And I went, wow, people do this for a living. And if you're listening right now and you're thinking I'm a pussy, well, I am. 727-579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. It just makes you realize that, like, I don't know, work is hard. 579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. Just had somebody call in. I had to dump them because they swore, but they said I suck. Well, guess what? I'm here because Mike Calta agrees that I am very good on air. And if you call into a radio show that you don't like and you say that their radio show sucks, well, the radio show won. I never got people that did that. I also don't get why John Kerry Group is calling people when they shouldn't be. Oh, yeah, you shouldn't call them at 352-593-0425. It's 352-593-0425. You shouldn't call. Can you imagine being a scammer? Like, whenever I get those scam calls, I often wonder, like, are they able to look themselves in the mirror? Like, I remember one time I was talking to a radio guy, and he told me he was talking about one of his rivals. And he told me that the rival was talking about how he was talking bad about his co-host. And on Twitter, he went on and said, oh, he was talking bad about his co-host. And the radio guy that I knew said, no, I was just sending out critiques that I have said to his face. So then he sent a text to that dude that was on Twitter and said, hey, if you are able to look yourself in the mirror, that's all that matters. And to me, I take pride every night that I am able to look myself in the mirror. Sometimes I have critiques, how I could be better on the radio, how I could be better as a boyfriend, as a cat owner. But let me tell you, if you are not able to look yourself in the mirror, because there was a point in my life that I was not, I would avoid the mirror every time I would go to the bathroom at Cox Media. I would avoid the mirror every time I was at my apartment because I was not happy with myself. But then when you begin to become happy with yourself, it's the most beautiful thing, because then you realize that in your short lifetime, you were hating on yourself over problems that nobody cares about. Do you ever think about that? Like, for example, I was at the Peppa Pig Park, and, like, everything's going on in the Ukraine, and my back hurt from working this week. And I was like, nobody cares about this problem. Not one person has any issue with what I'm going through. It is all in your mind. And if you are out there and you're getting offended and you're going, sure, people care about my problem. They really don't. Do you think anybody else is thinking about you? It's the most humbling thought ever. There are 8 billion people on this planet or whatever, and they're not thinking about you. But this person is because they called in. Hi, you're on the air.
Hey, Hoppe, congratulations on your move, number one.
Thank you, Carol.
I'm so happy for you guys. You guys need to talk to that guy. What is he on Saturday? The real estate quarterback?
He is on Sunday mornings at 7 a.m. Very good show.
You need to call him. And yeah, he is. Talk to him because let him get you guys a house. It would be a lot better if you have an investment.
Wait. How do you get a house with inflation? And I'm not complaining about money. I'm not the radio guy that goes, oh, money sucks or whatever when you're not making a lot. I keep that private. I don't talk about it. But how am I supposed to get a house if I can't afford it? You know what I mean?
He has all the backings. If you're affording the money you're paying right now, that's what it would cost you for a mortgage. Plus, it's a tax write-off because you just bought a good investment. Real estate never fails.
I appreciate the call. I just think, I don't want to guess your age, but I think your generation had it easier. Like, the inflation rates, it's out of control because I just don't even know how we're going to afford this planet. I don't know where this is going, and this is not me doing doomsday radio, but I'm sincerely confused by where the planet's going. I don't know.
I know. But every 10 years, pretty much, or give or take a little, we seem to go through an inflation. So just hang on tight, and I'm serious. Go talk to them. They will walk you through it. They're good.
All right, thank you. I didn't mean to hang up on her. 727-579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. I see this report here from Bro Bible, which when a person says that they have a news report from Bro Bible, you might think, oh, is that legitimate, Ryan Hoppe? Well, this is a site that will then take news from other sites and then repost it. And it says here that Aaron Rodgers reportedly wants a massive raise next year. I don't get Aaron Rodgers' cockiness. Sure. Is he one of the greatest football players of all time? Perhaps. He also has not won a Super Bowl in the last decade and 2 years. It was like 2011, 2010. And when Aaron Rodgers won that Super Bowl, he had to beat the Atlanta Falcons, which Michael Vick threw that interception, and then he played it was the Eagles that Michael Vick threw that interception, and then he beat Matt Ryan, and then he beat Caleb Haney because Jay Cutler got hurt. I think it's time for us to have an open discussion on the fact that Aaron Rodgers is a choke artist. Now, is he one of the best to ever play? Yes, but does he deserve a raise? No. He did absolutely nothing in the playoffs. Every year we go, oh, this is Aaron Rodgers' year. This is Aaron Rodgers' year. And he'll put up MVP numbers, and he'll put up amazing numbers, and he'll be amazing. And then come to playoffs, it's not like he has an awful game, but you would think you're watching, like, Derek Carr or somebody. You're like, you literally play. Now, nobody wants to live in Green Bay, but a lot of players would love to play in Green Bay. I've been to Green Bay. Imagine what you think of Green Bay, and that's what it is. But literally, you have this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to win a Super Bowl every year, and then you just play very clunky, and you play very awkward and very robotic. I just don't get where Aaron Rodgers comes from, where he wants more money if he's just choking every year in the playoffs. Hi, A13, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up, man?
What's happening, bro?
Just want to say you do a good job of naturally speaking on the radio. So there's no awkward pauses, and while you're figuring yourself out, it's like having a conversation while driving at work. So really appreciate it, man.
That means a lot, man, because like I find haters funny because they don't realize how much they love me. For example, my true hater, my man, first of all, what's your name?
JD.
My true hater is my ex-girlfriend, and I'm not talking about the past, but my ex-girlfriend who dumped me at the Target on Dale Mabry and said she never wanted to talk to me again. And I dropped her off at her apartment, and I have not talked to her since. That's a true hater. Even my first girlfriend, me and her made up. We went out drinking. We're cool now. But if you're calling a radio show, so you got to type in a number and maybe leave your job site for a second and then go on air and swear and say that I suck, deep down, you kind of like me a little bit. Just a little bit.
And their girlfriends probably dumped them at Walmart. So at least you got that going for you.
Hell yeah, bro. Thank you for the call. That wouldn't be a bad place, you know. Me and my girlfriend do have this joke every time we go to Target. I'm like, babe, I love you. Hi, you're on the air.
Hey, a little earlier you guys were talking about the phone call scammers.
Yeah, what's happening?
You know, this might seem a little immature, but at times, man, I have so much fun trolling them and getting them with these nuts jokes.
Yeah.
And sometimes you get a female Indian chick and you just play with her a little bit, joke around.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's just, you know, give them a little dose of their own medicine. They went and waste people's time. You waste a little bit of their time. Have a little fun if you got a free minute or two. Obviously, if you're at work, you can't do it.
Well,
I love the show, buddy.
Thank you, bro. All right, thank you. Hi, you're on the air.
Hey, I love your show. You're doing a great job.
Thank you.
And as far as your housing situation,
yes.
What was the name and phone number of that scumbag lawyer, real estate guy, scumbag real estate guy in Spring Hill? Maybe we can call him to find a house.
352-593-0425.
Good luck to you.
I will. Thank you. I think we don't need to wish me good luck because I'm able to manifest it. But if I was John Kerry, I'd be praying to the Lord that doesn't exist.
Happy hour. Happy hour.
It's the Mike Calta After Show on 102.5 The Bone. Now, back to the Mike Calta After Show.
Happy hour. Happy hour.
A lovely day.
It is a lovely day. We are on the right side of the ground.
A lovely day.
727-579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. I have a few calls to get to, but I want to let you guys know about the best programming in all of radio. Up next is the best of Roger and JP. Then it's Drew Garabo Live with John Senning and Joey Flash. Then it's the Cad Named Mo Show with Dizzy and Spike. Then Johnny B. And then tomorrow, when I tell you that we have the best lineup in all of weekend talk radio, hell, we have the best lineup in all of Tampa radio. I'm a man of my words. From 5 to 8 a.m., it's Tampa Bay Fishing Radio with Captain Zach and Gray Birchall. Then it's the Attorney Patrick Smith Show from 8 to 9. Then it's Rock Hard with Mike Olivero from 9 to 10. And then it's the Weekly Checkup, Migs and Swig, the Mike O Radio Show. And then we got NASCAR. We got replays. So let me tell you, if you're not listening to 102.5 The Bone, man, you are always missing out. You listen to other radio shows in different towns, and they'll talk for 7 minutes, and then do traffic and weather, and then it's enough of that. But here we talk for 42 minutes an hour because we want to entertain the hardworking average Joe and Jane that grind in life. We really do care. All right, we got a few calls to get to, but if you want to call in, phone lines are wide open. We got four lines open. 727-579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. All right. Hi, you're on the air. Who's this?
This is Brennan.
What's happening?
Hey, man. First thing I want to say is I didn't hear that first call, but whoever that guy was, he doesn't understand the show, apparently. Usually there's five of you guys doing this. It's a lot easier to do with five people than it is to do it all by yourself.
And it's
I think you've been doing...
Thank you.
I think you've been doing a great job.
Well,
seriously.
I had to dump it because he swore, but it was essentially he called in and said the F word, and he's like, this sucks. Go back to the after show. I'm like, well, Calta granted me this opportunity, and the other thing is, like, everybody hates Logan Paul. Everybody hates Pete Davidson and that, but it's like, hey,
right.
You know what I mean? Like, they are known. They're known. You know, like if you're talking about me, love or hate, on the chat room or whatever, that's fine. I don't care. I really don't.
Yeah, it's cowardice.
It is.
But here's the way I would have finished that call with him.
How?
I bet I can do your job, but I know you can't do mine.
Hell yeah, bro. My thing, though, my thing is that was very much me 3 years ago. But here's what I learned about haters is haters want you to respond because it gives them dopamine. And then they go to they go to being douchebags. So I just dump the guy and I don't give him airtime. It's like, hey, if you're going to be a jerk off and call while I'm trying to produce great radio, I'm not going to get you on air.
Yeah. Yeah, right. And then that's what I say. Like I said, you know I can do your job, whatever it is, but I guarantee you can't do mine. You guys put on the greatest show. I quit listening to the radio about 6 years ago when I started working for myself and started listening to Bone all day long.
Dude,
my customers don't mind it. They like it better than that rap stuff and everything else the lady yells at me about. And it's just, I've learned so much talking to you guys, especially about the local community, like with Calta, the way he works with everybody. I called in on the Calta thing about that John Kerry,
I'm going to
call John Kerry. I got something for him. I guarantee he's listening right now if he's smart, which he didn't act like. But if he's smart enough to listen to you guys right now and try to do some damage control.
To me, that's like beating a dead horse, though. That's a Mike Calta thing. I just wanted to throw my shot at him, but I wish him nothing but the best. I just don't like getting scam calls. Do you have any fun plans this weekend?
You know what's funny is I actually got my taxes back this morning.
Oh, you did?
And we're going to shelter the dogs, and we don't even know where we're going. We're going to get in the car and haul butt. We don't have any kids. We're in our 50s.
Yeah.
Well, we have kids. They're gone. And I'm going to shelter the dogs, and we're going to haul butt. I think we're going to New Orleans. We don't even know yet.
Dude, you should just drive and just see what's going on. Because, like, I don't ever want to leave America. I just want to see America, man.
Dude. Well, you're lucky that you're young enough and you care about doing it, so do it. I'm 55, and we've done it in Florida. I know every beach and every bar in Florida.
Yeah.
You know, I've played most of them. I used to be in a traveling two-man band. And then my wife and I, since I met her when she was 18, and we have gotten in a car and just driven. Like, we drove to Rolling Stones concert, and we didn't even have tickets. We went down to Miami and just got a hotel room and went and stood in the parking lot till we got tickets. I mean, we do cool stuff like that, like what you're saying. So I appreciate it. But like I said, man, that guy didn't know what he was talking about, man. Apparently he doesn't listen to you guys' show very much.
I appreciate that, man.
It takes five people to do that, and you're doing it all by yourself. So you're handling it pretty good, bro.
Thank you, homie. I appreciate that.
Yes, sir. Have a good day, and have a great weekend.
All right, you too. Peace out. Hi, you're on the air.
Hoppe.
What up?
This is Giovanni, man. What's going on, brother?
What's happening, bro?
Man, I kind of second that last guy. I've been listening for a long time.
Yeah.
And first of all, man, support the rap community because the rap community supports us.
Oh, especially, I love the rap community. I listen to rap all day. Yeah. That's all I listen to.
Yeah, I'm not you. I'm talking about the other guy. But anyway, you're my Bitcoin, Hoppe. I got in when you first started there, and I'm vested. I'm vested in the Hoppe coin. You hear me? I'm going all the way to the moon with Hoppe.
Hell yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
Dude.
Hell yeah.
That's the same thing, that is the same thing my girlfriend said, because she was dating me for a year and a half now. And that's the same thing she says. We call it the Hoppe coin. Also, I could be an NFT or whatever those things are. It's all a Ponzi scheme, but I'll take the money.
Hey, man, I'm black. I don't want nobody owning any part of me no more. But listen, check this out, though.
What?
As far as a house, 3 years ago, my dude, I was in Clearwater.
Yeah.
I didn't have, man, I wasn't poor, but yeah. I didn't have hardly anything.
No, I feel you.
And fast forward, I own a house. 3 years later, the house has tripled. We took a little bit out, built the guest house. It's even gotten more value. I'm only saying that to say I had no clue it was going to even be possible. Do yourself the favor, take the time to at least look, and I guarantee you, you will be surprised at who will lend you money. Especially now, the banks have hundreds of thousands of houses. They're not realtors.
Yeah.
They want to get rid of them.
No, I appreciate
that. Keep that in mind, man. Yeah, and when you actually release your Hoppe coin, man, I'm going to ask for my piece.
I'm down, bro. Message me on social media so I know which one you are. Sounds good, bro?
I got you, bro. Yeah, I got you.
All right, thank you, homie.
Later.
All right, peace. Hi, you're on the air. Hi.
What's going on, Hoppe at Soda?
What is going on, Soda? What's happening? The best rapper out of Sarasota. What's happening, homie?
Not much, buddy. Just want to tell you, this show is way better than that rap crap I hear on the radio.
Oh, man, dude. I don't get the haters. You know, like, it's not even like, oh, like, there's not enough time in a day for it. I don't care. I just, they're so mad. I'm like, what do you care? Why are you so mad? Like,
You love it, Hoppy. You love it, bro.
I like
you
it to a
it.
Point.
Don't lie, you love it.
I like it to a point, and it's just like, if I'm doing a good job, but you're just going to say I sucked because you're thinking about my whole time at the Bone. Because there's just some people that don't want to accept that I'm good at what I do now. I was just very much a mess when I moved here. Had a lot of things going on in my personal life, and I just came from a very awful show in Cleveland.
Bro, I've watched your journey, bro. You've had quite a journey, bro. It's been a pleasure to watch, bro.
So what's going on in the life and times of Soda?
Today I'm in Waco, Texas, actually picking up some freight and going to Sarasota, Florida to drop off at Sarasota Memorial.
Dude, so would you say the Bone gets you through the driving? Because you are putting in a lot of hours, my friend.
Yeah, I do about 3,000 to 5,000 miles a week out here, and definitely Bone TV. I got you guys on the app.
Oh, hell yeah, so, dude. Let me tell you real quick.
Helps pass the time.
In any other town, I mean, and when I say town, people will literally think about actual population. That's a Midwest term for a big city, because people will be like, why do you say it's the biggest show in town? Like, that's not me literally saying a town. It's just my slang. But let me tell you, in other towns, there's radio show hosts that think they are better than the listeners. They think they are better than everyone they work with. But the best part about Mike Calta is that guy, man, he is as genuine as it comes. Like, I am very grateful to have him. Like, he is the GOAT.
Yeah, man. And sometimes I'll try the other stations in other states and stuff, bro, and they don't compare, bro. And you guys have solid shows from Mike Calta to Roger and JP to Cat Named Mo to Drew Garabo and John. You know, you guys just all kill it, bro, all day long. I enjoy it. I appreciate it.
Keep doing it. Thank you, sir. As Mike O has said on the Mike O radio show every Saturday from 2 to 4, it's like we have 5 morning shows all day long, essentially.
Yeah, yeah. You guys are definitely an all-star stack team, man.
So I don't get paid when I ask you this, but where can people find your music?
Spotify, iTunes, just search Soda, S-O-T-A, like Sarasota.
Yeah.
And the albums are State of the Art 1 and State of the Art 2. And can I plug my YouTube channel, man, that I'm doing right now?
Hell yeah, man.
All right. If people want to check out what I'm doing right now on the road, it's called Expediting America.
Yeah.
That's E-X-P-I-D-I-T-I-N-G, Expediting America on YouTube.
What's the weirdest thing you've seen driving across America? Like, what's one thing everyone talks about? Inflation, or people losing their houses, and that's awful. But what's like the one thing that you see that no one's talking about?
The one thing that I see that nobody's talking about, man.
Or what do you notice?
How dirty a lot of these major cities are. You know, like just how filthy and a lot of these big towns are, these big cities, and especially California, like L.A.
Yeah.
I remember going to L.A. when I was younger, man, and it's way different. It's like, it's horrible, bro.
Dude, how sad was that before the Super Bowl when they were just like, essentially they got like they were sweeping up dirt off the ground, but they were just sweeping away the homeless people outside of SoFi. They were like, get away. Like, can't you get them help? Think about all the billionaires and millionaires that went to the Super Bowl, even 100,000-aires, and you each give them $5. Because to me, homeless people out there, people will hate on homeless people and say, oh, they had a drug problem. I'm not going to go into that. But there's some legitimate homeless people that just could not afford to live in California, especially like in San Jose, Berkeley, San Francisco. That's where it gets nuts.
Yeah, it's kind of ironic, man, when you think about how much money was spent on the Super Bowl and what that could do for people. But at the same time, you know, it is what it is, and there's a plan for everything, and there's a reason why everything is the way it is right now, bro.
Hell yeah, man. As I like to say, and I've heard my whole life, keep grinding, Soda.
Thank you, man. I appreciate you, Hoppy. Keep killing it, bro. You're doing a great job.
Thanks, homie. Let's go to this next call. Hi, you're on the air.
Thank you for using where's my cell phone.com.
Oh, where's my cell phone? Oh, man. Spam calls are getting out of control. There's times that I'm literally meditating, and I'll get a call from, like, Illinois because I have an Illinois number, and I'm like, what are you even doing? What are you even doing? Now, that phrase I just said, what are you even doing, I think could also go with the MLB because they are at odds. Everybody is. And baseball doesn't have a lot of fans, and the fans that do exist in baseball are diehard, and you are alienating them. And let's see what's going on from Wendy Ryan at ABC Action News.
Talks between Major League Baseball players and owners continue as both sides try to end that ongoing lockout. Our Kevin Lewis explains why reaching a labor agreement is just the first step toward baseball coming all the way back to Tampa Bay.
They need to just end the lockout right now. I don't care what money is involved. You literally had the Atlanta Braves, a major market with an okay fan base, win their first World Series since I was 2 years old, and nobody cared. The World Series ratings were at an all-time low. If I am the MLB, I am thanking whatever amount of viewers they had, the few millions they had for the World Series, and I am thanking the fake man up in the sky known as God for that, because 727-579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. I just don't get what baseball is doing. It's like they're trying to alienate anything they have. And to me, I don't know much about baseball because I quit caring when the Cubs won, because the Cubs winning to me was all I ever needed. And then when they won and then they just went to crap afterwards, that was good. But back then when they had the commissioner, Bud Selig, they seemed to be trying a little harder. But this guy that's running the MLB and all the players, get over yourself. Just get back to playing. People want you.
Rays broadcaster and former major leaguer Brian Anderson says that because major league players can't have contact with team officials, getting a deal done means more work across the league.
Oh, yeah, that's totally happening. They're not communicating at all. Get out of here.
You all of a sudden now have a lot of free agents that are still out there that need to sign, trades that need to be made, foreign-born players that need to get their visas approved and need to get them into the United States and then get them to camp. And
then I saw, I don't know the name of the baseball player because I don't watch baseball because it's incredibly boring and I don't have the attention span for TikTok, so how would I watch baseball? But I saw some baseball player, I think it was for like the Angels or something, right before the lockout, he was offered $200 million but said it was not enough. And I was like, oh, that was not a smart decision.
Get everybody on the same page.
The Rays will play whatever home games they have this season at Tropicana Field. Now, the league nixed a plan of splitting the season between the Trop and Montreal.
That's like an open marriage that will not work out.
But Rays owner Stu Sternberg doesn't think that concept is dead.
Personally, I happen to think that partial seasons are going to be the wave of the future.
No, they're not. Who wants a partial season? You can't even get anything here. And I don't even know why everyone hates the Rays because I'm indifferent. I just didn't feel the fandom. I lived off of 22nd Avenue North for 6 years, and that's literally the Rays area, and nobody cared. So how are you going to have a split season? It's like Kyrie Irving not getting vaccinated. I don't care, but how are they going to win the championship if he can't play home games? So what's going to happen? The Rays begin the year and are super hot and the best team in baseball, and then they go to Canada? And then all of a sudden we're supposed to like root for them up in Montreal? Like, what? What?
Professional sports. And I think it's something that probably would have served this community and other communities well. That doesn't rule out the option of doing a full season here as well, though.
I just don't get what he has against the Bay Area. Baseball didn't even work in Montreal. They literally moved to Washington to become the Nationals in like 03, 04, 05-ish. So why would you want to go to a market that didn't even care about it? Oh, that's right, because you're cheap. You literally let every single baseball player that's ever good leave. Maybe it's you that should be leaving.
But what about the players who would actually have to live a split schedule?
And then all of a sudden we're going to pick up and move to Montreal. All the while we still got road trips going on, and we've got families, and we've got kids in school, and we've got doctors and places to live. I mean,
This just in, besides the Vinnick family, most sport owners are douchebags. So I don't think he really cares. He's thinking about the money, which I can't imagine there being any money playing in Montreal, though.
And there's so much at play there. I just thought, like probably most people, how in the world are they going to make that work?
The new stadium discussion continues, and Anderson told me the best solution is probably a move to Tampa proper.
When you look at where Tropicana Field is located, and you look at that 30-mile radius around it, it's a lot of water.
All righty, I don't care anymore. 727-579-1025 and 1-800-771-1025. Here's the deal. We're about to end the show, but up next is Roger and JP, followed by Drew Garabo Live, and a cat named Mo, and Johnny B. And then tomorrow, Tampa Bay Fishing Radio, Attorney Patrick Smith Show, Rock Hard, the weekly checkup, Migs and Swig with Don Migs and Lisa DiBartolo, and then the Mike O. Radio Show. And then Sunday, if you were working this week and you were not able to listen live, don't worry. Don't have a panic attack. You can always listen on Sunday for the replays. And you can listen on the 102.5 The Bone app, which is the best app in radio. And if you want to hear more of my show, every single major platform that has a podcast, search up Hoppe Radio, H-O-P-P-E Radio. This has been Hoppe Hour, filling in for the Mike Calta After Show. I appreciate you listening, and I hope you have the best weekend of all time.
Hoppe Hour. Hoppe Hour.
It's the Mike Calta After Show on 102.5.